Hi everyone, my name is Manuel and I'm a PhD student from the Institute of Sustainable Agriculture in Córdoba, Spain, and I'm going to talk about unraveling the whole genome of olive antagonistic psyllium inhabiting bacteria to fight vascular plant pathogen in olive trees. First, I'm going to give you a brief introduction. Today, there are two vascular pathogens that are threatening olive crop worldwide. One of them is Verticillium dalea, that is a fungal soil-borne pathogen, and the other is the psyllium-limited bacterium Psyllella fastidiosa, that is transmitted by psyllium sap feeding insect. In both cases, the symptoms start with the chlorosis and necrosis of the leaf, followed by the death of the branches, and finally the death of the whole tree because of the obstruction of psyllium vessel where the psyllium sap flows. This psyllium sap is colonized by a series of microbial communities that live in the host without hurting. And in these microbial communities interact each other and with abiotic and abiotic factor in order to proceed and to produce a series of key responses that impact on plant health and plant growth. So the objective of this work is to investigate the role of the olive psyllium macrobiota as a sort of biocontrol agent to confer protection against the psyllium inhabiting pathogen, Verticillium dalea and Psyllella fastidiosa. According to the material method section, we started by obtaining a bacterial culture collection from healthy olive trees, cultivated olive trees and wild olive trees. We selected Piquan, which is highly susceptible to the pathotype, to the defoliating pathotype of Verticillium dalea, which is more severe and has a major virulence, and susceptible to the not defoliating. Also, we selected Arbequina, which is susceptible to the defoliating and moderately resistant to the non-defoliating pathotype. Also, we selected as wild olive tree, Acebuche, which is moderately resistant to defoliating and remaining unknown to non-defoliating. After that, we selected these branches and we followed two different approaches in order to extract the psyllium sap. First, we select a Scolander chamber device. So we put our branches inside this device and we increase the pressure in order to obtain this psyllium sap. On the other hand, we made small woody pieces by sterile scalpel in order to obtain this woody chip. Both this psyllium sap was cultured in different culture media. And after that, we obtained this psyllium bacterial collection that was composed of 261 strains that are grouped in 39 genera. After that, in order to perform this experiment, we made a selection of this strain. So we selected at least one strain per genera, and also we selected more strains from genera described as a biocontrol agent. So in total, we selected 108 psyllium bacterial strains. According to the Verticillium dalea isolation, we selected the defoliating and the non-defoliating strain that infect olive and one strain that infect tomato. These are our three Verticillium dalea strains. And also, as a culture media, we use the olive psyllium sap and TSB as a control culture media. Also, we selected three predefined culture media similar to the chemical properties of olive psyllium sap. Once we have everything, we perform our high throughput fungal bacteria interaction screen method. So we have on one hand the screen plate that contains the strain plus Verticillium spores and the background plate, which contains the strain, the media, the different Verticillium spore of the each strain used. All of these plates were incubated for 6 days at 25 degrees. Now I'm showing you some results. These results are based on the relative growth index, that is a log 2 transform fluorescent values that reflect the ability of a bacteria of a specific strain to promote or to restrain the fungal biomass. Each point in this square represents one strain and is the RGAI average of three experimental replicates. The point on the left restrain the fungal biomass, and the point on the right increase the fungal growth. We selected from the previous one those strains with high effect on Verticillium. So here in this table, I show you the number of strain, the antagonistic activity against a specific Verticillium strain, and the culture media where take place this interaction. So for example, here, if we observe the Pyrogobacterium, it is the same strain, 98, but for example, here in TSB, it has an antagonistic effect against the defoliating. In TSB, has a neutral effect on the no defoliating strain of Verticillium. And on the contrary, in XF26, has a positive effect against Verticillium defoliating strain. Also, we performed this experiment with the Silensa, and we selected and identified the bacteria with the highest effect against this strain of Verticillium, those who restrict or promote the fungal biomass, no? The Verticillium growth. So now we are sequencing the whole genome of this bacteria using nanopore technology. So genome annotation using RAST showed that Methylobacterium, one of the Methylobacterium strains with the maximum number of coding sequencing, while Microbacterium presenting the lowest number. Also, if we represented this coding sequencing in a Venn diagram, we can see the shared and unique coding sequencing of this specific strain. So for example, they share 582 coding sequencing genes. And for example, it's interesting to see how this differences in the strain of Methylobacterium. One strain promote the fungal biomass and the other strain restrict, no? this fungal biomass. And they have 300 specific coding sequences. So finally, as a conclusion, we can say that the culture media where the fungal bacteria, the bacteria-fungal interaction takes place, affect the antagonistic activity of oleocilin-inhabiting microorganisms against Verticillium dahlia, that a specific bacteria strain can restrict, promote, or be neutral depending on the Verticillium dahlia strain, and finally, that a specific strain presents unique coding sequencing that might help to unravel the mechanism behind the antagonistic activity of this ceiling-inhabiting microorganism against vascular pathogen. So I would like to thank you all this supporting project. Thank you for all the members of my group. I thank you. You are for listening. Thank you.